We're here today on the shores of the Red Sea in the Lower Hejaz Mountains to visit one of the newest circuits on the Formula One calendar. We're in Jeddah, home to what we all hope is going to be a thrilling Saudi Arabian Grand Prix. So let's take a look at the topographical map of the Jeddah Street Circuit. As you can see, a number of challenging corners for the drivers to master here. We'll see just how much the teams have benefited from their time spent in practice this weekend.
Bloody hell.
And like many street circuits, this track has the potential to punish drivers that get it wrong. Let's hope we avoid any safety cars today.
Mm-hmm.
It's time to take a look at our starting grid for today's race. Max Verstappen put in a fantastic lap yesterday, and he'll start from pole position, with Charles Leclerc alongside. As we continue through the rest of the grid today, we have Sainz, Wang, Lando Norris, and Perez, Vettel, Ocon, Ricciardo, and Kevin Magnussen, Russell, Gasly, Robert Schwartzman, and Bottas, Hamilton, Joe,
what the hell's happened to
Alex
Mercedes?
Albon and Mick Schumacher, Tsunoda, Stroll, Latifi, and Oscar Piastri. Now it's almost time for lights out, so let's go down to the track. And alongside me once again for coverage of today's race is none other than the great Anthony Davidson. Come on then, let's talk about Alpine. We have a number of changes to the aerodynamic regulations this year, and the signs haven't looked good for them so far in terms of getting to grips with those changes.
There are a few downcast looks within the team this weekend. I think they've been hit fairly hard by the new regs, but this is only the first step down a long road of development, and even if they don't maximise their points today, there are plenty more up for grabs this season.
Okay, now that we've got some good points on the board, let's continue this form and aim for another top 10 finish.
We'll do 54.5 laps for the fuel. Back. Personalised hards to mediums is interesting. I might... degrees, bloody hell. Right, we'll do that. Formation lap.
Okay, so our system checks are good. We need to stay in formation and start bringing the car up to temperature, please. Get some load into the tyres and work the brakes. We want them nice and warm by the end of this lap.
Some on softs and some on hards. Some very different strategies taking place here. We have got a pair of softs, so if worst comes to worst, we can get onto some softs and try and put some work on them. Getting the rear up to temperature by doing a bit of the old drift-o. There we fucking go, ladies and gentlemen.
There, nice one. That's going to give you the edge if you can get good launch as the race starts. Keep an eye on the lights. The start sequence will begin as...
Got one!
Okay,
really struggling with grip. Here comes Sebastian Vettel. And you're going to be saying that a lot this year. Well, he's on the soft, maybe I should let him do his best work. I didn't see you there, I'm really sorry. Oh god. Well, I'll let you pass because you got softs. I'll let you pass. You don't make me move. I'm not going to make it too easy for you. I'm going to move to the face myself. Come on.
We've got a lot of spare energy.
There's some cool drifting to let you pass. Bloody hell, Gasly's doing well. I wonder if we should restart this because of the simple fact that. Let me just flashback. Like, if we've got that damage that I haven't realised yet, we're going to restart. That damage that I got on would have just been a nightmare for 25 laps. What is Lando Norris doing? If these two can carry on fighting with each other, there's a chance I can possibly break into the lead. That's going to be a disaster.
DRS will be enabled this lap. You can use it when you're within 1 second of the car ahead and in the DRS zone.
Making up places, baby. Completely lost the rear end through half them corners. Tyres must be getting hot, I think, is the problem with them. Thank you. Sign seems to break a load earlier there. Just get past. Well, you know you want to. For the first time this season, I'm leading a race. If Ezra didn't lead it at any point last time. And like actually lead it, not just from like pit stops or anything. Okay, 10% on the tyre. I think we can go for quite a long time on it. It's amazing how well the two hard people, no, that's a terrible sentence, two hard tyred cars are still holding in first and third. And the softs just haven't blasted past them. I think Norris is trying to get past Verstappen on them soft. Try and get some use out of them before he has to switch them out. That will probably come up soon, I imagine. He's going to do about 15 laps, so they're about halfway through their tyre. Not less than 15 laps, so. Oh, I know what's his face died today. Ken Block, but crikey, it's a bit Jim Carnery sometimes trying these corners. Yeah, I think drivers just shouldn't get on, shouldn't do stuff on the snow. This is a fun track again. Have the issues with them corners, other than that, it's a really fun track.
Our gap behind is 6.1 seconds.
Oop, softs are beginning to pit, I think. What was that, 8 laps? Christ. Left, I think, is going for one more lap. Yep. 8 or 9 laps really is the limit on the softs. Guys are up in 5th, I'm very impressed with. Tesla's going for another lap, I think. Brave lad. Making most of his time up in the top spot. Slow over there I was last time. This is like some 2020 shit where the AlphaTauri was just insane. Beating the Red Bull half the time. I think that was 2020, wasn't it? Not quite there, but it's still really impressive. Slightly scared at how quickly these tyres are disappearing under me. Oh, Windows Defender, suck my knob! Are you going to stay there? Oh, thank you. Not the time to do that.
Didn't receive that. Repeat the message. Repeat the message. You're leading the pack. That's P1. Verstappen behind you now. And the gap behind us is 8.6 seconds. Okay, they're on old hard tyres. And that's 13 laps now until your pit window's open. 38 laps to go.
We'll do the same again. So much slower than that. Mid-session save, so if anything happens, we don't lose our progress. Also, let's just have a quick look at the race director. So Vettel's on a lot of the softs will go on to mediums. The one medium, and Daniel Ricciardo is sort of sat in the middle of nowhere. But all the soft mediums are in the bottom half of the time. So Vettel possibly struggling a little bit. Say that they think that the Alpine guys haven't adapted well to the aerodynamics changes. I think they're doing quite well, really.
Okay, so we're leading our teammate by 25.7 seconds.
Well, they've lost Alonso for Schwartz, really. There's a bit of a difference there. That's 103 years, mostly. Let's take the sector to drive, it's the fastest. Half the time. Almost up to a free pit stop.
Okay, be aware, the grip levels are going to start falling away soon.
The more these tyres are falling off, the more fast they've come on, certainly more fun to drive. Now there's a bit of slip in the car. It doesn't feel quite as precise, yes, but feels quick. Pop that up. Stepping in the fastest lap. There in the pits. I can have a free pit stop. Oh my god, didn't need it then. Now I've got a free pit stop. And we're currently in a 1-2 configuration.
Levi.
Nicholas Latifi's out of the session, whatever will we do? What has happened to Nicholas Latifi? Oh, his engine just died. He hasn't actually binned it, which is rare.
Yellow flag. Okay, be aware, there's an incident in the next part of the track. No overtaking through the yellow flag.
I think he's in a somewhat sensible place.
Green flag.
They've put less wear on them this time. Compared to what I thought I was going to do. Might have been at 50, but I'm only at 40, probably 45 by the time I actually change, sorry. They're struggling a little bit on them. It's a high pressure circuit. By Christ, it's a fun one. So if you just fix that corner that I have issues with. I can put the power on a bit more when I'm a little bit further away from the wall because I know I'm not going to slide into it. Fastest lap on a really old set of halves is quite a good achievement. Teammates in the pits again.
Sebastian's in for his stop.
Another set of mediums, I guess. Don't know what the entrance to this is like. That's terrible.
That was a fantastic stop, faster than we were expecting. Up to speed now, let's get some heat into those tyres.
Safe. Oh, go downstairs and see what's happening with that. And if it is soon, we'll leave that and come back to you. So see you all very shortly. Right, it's been a little while, so hopefully I'm not completely terrible. But let's go. Oh, that's a bit. Taking the piss. You're like, no, don't be terrible, please. In fact, we're already up near 20% burn, it's kind of great. Christ, now how this game expected me to do more laps than these naked tyres. Possibly best I've ever gone through that. I believe is the phrase. Wonder. There was an incident. No. Oh, he just needs to choose a new tactic with medium mediums. Where is he going soft to the end? Left off, so don't think I gained any from the love, and it was a genuine off. Passion and Joe are using my DRS.
I need to miss it.
Vettel's moving up the order. Don't think he's going to get plenty of stepping in the sixth lap, but...
No need to worry about the tyre condition for now. Everything's looking good.
Usually means you have two or three laps before everything starts going really bad. Actually coming up on quite a hill. Ooh, we're breaking quite a bit away. So the rain gets here above down here. That's disappointing. Gastel was looking like fifth at one point. Must have had the wrong strategy or an accident or something. Tires look awful. Out. Pick this off to come out soon, maybe. Do some same lap to the end, but we'll leave it as is, don't want to risk anything. I'm willing to lose one fastest that point compared to five for winning the race. God, he's sticking with me though, he's really using the DRS. God, he's nearly killing me. Also. Thank you. don't need the mud. Yeah, the anti-aliasing on the tires looks terrible. Final lap, everybody, final lap.
Okay, this is your final lap of the race. Okay, we've only got one lap of fuel remaining.
Oh, I got a fuel bang on about right then. Yep. The tyres are starting to have a little bit of a problem, but no matter that.
Oh. That is the race win, my friend. Well done.
How come he gets driver of the day?
A hard-fought win today, then, after a very difficult race. Tell me, Ant, how do they manage to achieve this win?
Well, they certainly stood out as a driver with tons of confidence on the track. I think their ability to keep their cool, even during some of the more hectic parts of the race, meant they were able to capitalise on the mistakes of other drivers, giving them the opportunity to make their way to the top spot with ease.
Here comes your top three, making their way down to the podium for what can only be described as a fantastic day for Formula One.
Incredible scenes.
Let's have a quick look at how the driver's standings have changed. Wang takes over the lead of the Drivers' Championship. Let's focus on the driver of the day, Anthony Davidson. Who do you pick?
I have to say Sebastian Vettel certainly caught my eye during today's race. Incredible driving.
Let's move on to the constructors. The current leaders continue to extend their lead at the top. Meanwhile, Ferrari have improved their position. A strong weekend for them as they fight their way towards the top. Well, what an end to another fantastic weekend of racing. Thanks to everyone who joined us, and we'll see you for the next one.
Okay, let's have a look at the highlights.